8 months ago, college hockey came to an abrupt stop.
Tournament canceled.
Avoiding large crowds, social distancing.
It's unprecedented.
Suspended all in-person instruction on campus.
Tonight, after a summer of uncertainty, a refuge is finally found in a return to the rink and a puck on the ice. Hockey is back, and it returns tonight as the Wisconsin Badgers take on the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Hi, everybody. Welcome inside a mostly vacant but very energized Compton Family Ice Arena. I'm Tony Simeone. Happy to have you with us. Recently, it was unclear if these games would even be played, but after months of patience, planning, and protocols, we are finally ready for college hockey. So as I welcome in my broadcast partner tonight, Kendall Coyne Schofield, who is located just behind the glass. Kendall, we expect the hockey to look pretty familiar on the ice tonight, but it's the atmosphere in this building that should be different.
It will be different without fans, and I think the two things that these student athletes are going to miss the most is the student section and the band. But regardless, they can't let the lack of energy in this building dictate their energy on the ice. They need to find their energy from within and from within their teammates.
So as we shift our focus to these two teams, Wisconsin came in last in the Big Ten a season ago, but they're optimistic going into this season because they bring back the conference's leading scorer.
And that's Cole Caulfield. And are they thankful they have him back? They were unsure if he was going to return due to the uncertainty around the NCAA season being played, but he's back, and he's one of the most elusive and dynamic goal scorers in the entire NCAA. When number 8 in red is on the ice, Notre Dame has to have a check on him at all times. If not, he will make you pay and put it in the back of the net.
Well, the man that's going to have the toughest task of stopping Cole Caulfield tonight is Dylan St. Cyr, who finally has a chance as Notre Dame's number 1 goaltender.
And while we've waited 8 months for this puck to drop here tonight, Dylan St. Cyr has waited 21 months for the departure of Cale Morris. It is now his crease. While he's only 5'9", and he's a smaller goaltender, he makes up for it with his athleticism, with his stick work, and with the quickness of his feet. He's here to prove that this is his starting net, and he's going to do that here tonight.
These two teams have been eager to get back on the ice, and when we come back, they will do just that. It's Wisconsin and Notre Dame coming up next.